Hello, I am Sifu Andrew Platt, and today I want to run through the next in our series of syllabus, splashing hands, moves and drills. So again, we're just looking at the basics today for this level. Today is the third level, or the blue belt, the blue sash, and it's a build on from last time. So if you haven't spent a good 6 months or so working on the last syllabus's basics, level two, the yellow sash, then you don't move on to this one because it will become very difficult, and it will also make your shuffles very poor if you skip to this section quite quickly. The idea is you need a good base in the shuffles before you work on this drill. Now, in this drill, we will be working on jump shuffles and drop shuffles, okay? So these are very much conditioning and power training drills, okay? They're over-exaggerating the shuffle and making it work so your body mechanics and getting a greater spiral in motion in the waist from the floor. Now, these techniques are very, very tricky and they are very, very leg heavy, all right? So I suggest dedicating a lot of time to them, really working hard. And the more effort you put into these, the greater your reward will be. Now, I'll just very quickly go through the jump shuffle to begin with. Now, if we start from right side out, now on knees, you're meant to jump as far as you can, but if I do that, I'm gonna jump off screen. So I'm just gonna stay very close together, but you get the idea. So I'm gonna start here, okay? So we go into a shuffle like before. So knees touching, feet in a T stance. This foot straight, this foot on the toes in a T shape here. Now this puts all the weight into this leg, but the centre of gravity, again, as we said, is down the centre line of your body, so don't lean over. It's very easy to lean over during a jump shuffle to make it easier on yourself, but keep your back straight and push the feet down and you won't get a sense of what's really happening. I'll show you some good and bad points in a moment that most people acquire during these techniques. So from the shuffle, now the power should be in the centre, but we're going to push off the left foot because it's the most solid foot. Alright, so we're going to push off the flat left foot. And as we do that, we're going to push. You only move one foot at a time, but we're going to jump. So I'll do it slowly to start with a step. So you'll push off this foot and step. This foot is solid, if you can see that. And then this foot comes in. I'll move a little bit further back so you can see. So here, shuffle. Now we push off this foot and we jump. We step here, we place the foot solid, and this foot carries on. And it must land in a perfect shuffle, okay? If it's slightly off, you're going to hurt your knees because we're twisting at the wrong angle, because obviously there's a lot of force here going through the knees. So if we do it properly with a jump, you'll shuffle here, then you'll jump shuffle, one, two. And we're solid here, one, two. Don't jump up and down, keep your head level. We should glide this way, we should power off this foot and move this way. It works to keep your core here, squeeze your abs, squeeze your lower back, don't let your ass come out like this, keep it nice and solid, anyway. And two, okay? And the hand that's forward is the back foot that's on the twist. Now what I've seen many people do is when you get lazy, when you do a lot of repetition, you get tired, you get lazy, your shuffles go to pop. I've seen people don't even place this foot down. You just go one, two, three. This is bad. You need to be solid when you hit. This has to be solid. So you have to be in a good shuffle position. Alright, so again, just a quick point as well, just like the shuffle, this is a training drill, you wouldn't use it to hit this way, you would use it to hit a 45 degree angle. Just if someone's in front of me and I do a shuffle, jab, punch here, and then go for this one, if they're over there, I missed, I'm well out of the way. This is a very silly thing to do, it opens you up, creates space, and you're going to get kicked, punched, and anything else. What you do in a fight is you use it at a 45 degree angle this way to get around somebody's guard quite quickly. That way you can get to the side of a hammer fist and you can hit the kidneys, the side of the leg, the knee, the side of the head, and you can get around really quick and it takes them time to turn towards to face you. So it's a very useful technique. It also generates power. If you can do this on the spot when you shuffle, it teaches you how to generate power. Yeah, rather than just go like this and hit, oh yeah, body mechanics. Use power because you drop them. So when you do a shuffle here, you've got more power because you're stronger, you're more solid. Alright, so now that's covered, I'm just going to run through a couple of the basics on here. So this is a drill I use. I'll show you in a second, there's lots of different drills for this. Alright, so to start with, you pick one exercise, one basic move. Alright, so let's start with blocks, it's the most simplest. So we'll start with the inner block here, which we did in level one on the standing. Level two, with a shuffle. Now we're going to do a jump shuffle. So we start here in a nice basic stance. We half shuffle, just like before, with an inner block here. We cover the face here, and we're blocking, tucking the foot in, which you notice. I'm not going to go over it all, I'm just going to very quickly go through all of these. Then as we jump, again we don't drop the hands, we come straight from here, we do the jump shuffle here, and we hit here. And then we unshuffle. Okay, so one, two, unshuffle. One, two, unshuffle. One, two, unshuffle. You get the idea? So what we're doing is we're half shuffling here on the right hand. We jump shuffle to generate power with the left hand, which is the technique, and we unshuffle practice here. Then we do the same on the left side, repeat. We half shuffle on the left, and then we generate power with the right, and then we unshuffle back to the middle. So in one count, you're doing both moves. This will be one, and then two. Okay, nice and simple. So you're alternating sides, which means if you normally count to 50 on each side, you will do 100 in total without stopping. Now, a quick note with these as well, when we get onto the jab punch and the other hits, it's good to begin with to get the technique right. You go one, stop, two, stop, three, stop. But this is not how you use it. You use the mechanical waste and the elasticity power of the muscles to rebound. So once you hit here, you use this hit of the block to start the next move. So we hit here, bam, bam, bam. So it becomes rather than one, two, three, it becomes one move. One, two. And this should be done with good technique, but as quick as you can, and as far as you can remember. You should be able to jump halfway across the room, no problem, if you get the right leg straight. But again, without going up and down, it's good straight. Alright, so let's go very quickly in the block. Do the same with the outer block. One, two, here, one, two, here, one, two, here. Nice and easy. So we'll do the same with the down block, again covering the face. One, two, here, one, two, here, three, this one. You do it with the rolling block, which is a very good one. One, two, and reset. One, two, reset. One, two, reset. From there, up block as well, double block. One, two, and then one, two, this way, sorry. One, two, one, two, back. One, two, one, two, this way, with the roll as well. And then you do it with drop punch, and every block you've done in the syllabus you can do with this movement. Start with the jab punch now after that. Let's go for some attacks. So we can do it with just the jab, it's a very good drill. One, here, two, here, and reset. One, two, reset. One, two, reset. And again, I'm not going one, two, and then reset. Hits. One, two, reset. One, two, reset. So it bounces each time. Same with the punch jab. You can't do jab punch with this, it doesn't quite work, because your waist is twisting the wrong way. So what you would do is punch jab this way, and then jab punch this way. So you punch jab, jab punch. Punch, jab, jab, punch. Okay, so we're getting both moves in one count. Punch, jab first, jab, punch second. Otherwise the waist doesn't quite twist in the right direction. Okay, add-ons. Add-ons are good. So again, we've got the uppercut. So straight into the uppercut. One, here, to the ribs. Two, reset, cover the face. One, two, reset. One, two, reset. Now, forearm over the top. One, two, reset. One, two, reset. One, two, reset. Same with the punch here we did last time, driving into here, just between the navel and the hip bone there. Go one, two, reset, one, two, reset, one, two, reset. You can do it with the hammer fist. I like to go up here, just to get the right angle, but you could do out hammer fist here, reset. Or you could go up here, don't bring the shoulder up too much, this way. You can do it with one of the uncommon moves, this circular block here, so straight circular back twist here. One, two, reset. One, two, reset. One, two, reset, like that. You can go this way. One, two, reset. One, two. Now it's important on these two, those last two, not to go all the way around here and all the way around here. It must come out straight and turn. So you go in straight here, turn. Just because you do a drum shuffle doesn't mean this has to come bigger. It goes straight out and turn. Straight out, turn. Same with the back one here. You don't go round like this. Comes in, straight one, two, three, down the middle, hit to the back. This is to go forward. If someone changes last minute, you take a nice hit to the side. What else have we got on there? Okay, so one, two, three, four. You can do these all with elbows as well. Yes, yeah, so remember, An elbow is just a shortened version of these. If someone's here, you're not going to try and jump back to that uppercut. You're going to elbow, so you can elbow here, here, here. Yeah? So again, if we did this way as well, with a side elbow, you go one, two, reset, one, two, reset, one, two, reset. Downwards as well, but this one, two, reset, one, two, reset, one, two, reset. Upwards, done upwards, this way, back elbow, two, reset, one, two, reset, two, reset. Okay, nice and easy. The trick is, the add-on is always on, as we do here, with the foot that turns. It's always the foot that's turned with the shuffle, so you'll remember which foot it always is. The kicks are a good one. So if you do a straight kick like we did with a shuffle here, you go up and in and out and back. Takes a little bit longer this one, so you half shuffle, but down here, jump shuffle, kick in, and reset. One, jump shuffle, in, back down, reset. One, kick, back in, two, kick. So you can see on this one, there's only one kick per move, but you alternate legs each time. Okay, it's very important. Because you could go one here and jump shuffle and back in, but I like to just do one on that one. You can also do it with the sweep here. Here, turn, back in, back, reset. One, here, two, reset this way. Yeah, you get the idea with that one. You can do it with this one as well. Yes, you really play around with that one. So that's our jump shuffle technique, and you add all those into the other basics, which are very, very, very useful for generating power. Now, there is a second part to this syllabus, which isn't practiced very often, but is again very, very important. Now, this is the drop shuffle. Now, if you've not seen the drop shuffle before, it was based as a conditioned exercise, but I've found a lot of practical applicational use for this movement, which I'll go through in a second. So, it's a shuffle, but it's a drop shuffle. Now, it is what it says on the tin. So as we shuffle here, we drop down here. Watch your knees off you on concrete. If you're on the mat, you're right to the ground. We're in a good T stance, so you should see the knee come into the arch of the foot here, and the hands should cover just like up. Don't lean, keep the head back straight and back up. Now, obviously, your head is going up and down, but there's a purpose to that in a minute. I'll show you why. So, again, if you're doing a down block here, two, three, four, what this does, it gets you really good technique for your shuffles because you exaggerate the movement, you make it harder, you get stronger with the legs. So, when you do this, it feels easy. And becomes faster and stronger. Now, again, you can put the same movements from the shuffles, from last level into drop shuffles. Okay, now, the trick is with this as well, is you can do a jumping drop shuffle. Alright, so this is very, very tough on the legs, but very, very beneficial. Now, a lot of my students hate me for coming up with this one, but it's a very important drill to do. So, just as before, let's do it with the block so you can see the difference. Now, whereas we would normally go half shuffle, jump shuffle, reset, what we're going to do is half shuffle here into a drop shuffle. Alright, it's exactly the same thing, we're just dropping the knees. Now you can see where this is going. The jumping drop shuffle has to stay at height, this way and across this way. So let me do the full thing. We half shuffle, drop shuffle, jump shuffle, drop shuffle, unshuffle, drop shuffle. One, two, three. One, two, three. It's a very good way to start a class. Make sure you warmed up properly for this one, as it is quite strenuous to the knees, but you will strengthen the knees up and the ankles a lot on this one. Now, practical application. Let me just grab a bag for this one. Okay, hopefully you can see that. So I've got this one. So, if you've took someone down, let's say round three, the person on the floor, okay, now what you don't want to do, we know from Splash Hands, is come down with them. You don't want to get down here because this isn't where Splash Hands is good. If you worked on groundwork before, then that's fine. If you may have seen some of my ground and pound videos, if you know what you're doing on the ground, it's fine to take them down to the ground. But if you don't know what you're doing and you haven't trained Splash Hands from the ground, it's not a place you want to be. So, what you want to do is you want to attack without going down. So a drop shuffle is a knee, a drop knee, this way. And again, you're not still spending 20 minutes down here, just one hit to the ribs, back up. Use their body weight to thrust you back up, there won't be a hold on. You just want to fire down, fire up as quick as you can, drop shuffle as well, with the hands, this way, You're not jumping up to go down, you're just dropping the body weight. This way, you turn, same on this side. Now it's important for the knee to be bent. If the knee is not bent, you will dislocate your kneecap. Alright, if you hit slightly off, you'll just come up. The kneecap is strongest in a bent position here because it's tight, the ligaments are tight to protect it. That's why Thai boxers here have the knee up like this, you have it like this. You have it up like this, nice and tight with the knee forwards. Nice solid spear to hit with. So just drop down, keep your hands up. Here, unless obviously you're down there, and you keep your hands down. It's a very good one I found after Brown 3. If you do Brown 3 throw here, you usually have hold of an arm, or have the chance to have hold of an arm. Because you're not throwing someone for a punch, you've hit them a few times, they're a bit dazed, then as you throw, you may have hold of an arm, because that's what you've used to leverage over. If they're down and you've got hold of the arm, their ribs are exposed up and open like this on the ground. So we've got all this, and that'll just open the ribs up. And I can guarantee they're not going to get up from that. It's not a pleasant thing, and it should only be done in self-defense under extreme measures, but it is very, very useful skill. The second application for this is a takedown. Now, we don't do a lot of takedowns in Splash Challenge, but if you have done takedowns in other systems, it's very important to use, because a takedown comes from a low position, gets you out of head height, firing height, down here, and it allows you to grab the knees. Now, you see, if you haven't trained this, do not practice it in a real fight. You must practice takedowns in a controlled manner first, before applying them to street or self-defense. Because if you do it wrong, it could be catastrophic. You're down low, if you don't take somebody down, you're open to knees, elbows, yeah, not a very good idea. So you have to be 100% confident with your takedowns first. But I practice takedowns, so I like to use this one. So if you're fighting here, and you're here, don't ever just go straight into a takedown. Always apply shots first. So they're blocking, while the hands go up, you drop down. Usually at 45 angle, because it's straighter, more solid. You grab the back of the knees or the ankles, you lift up, close to the shoulder, protect their legs should be here, side of the head so you can't get hit, and then you lift up with the power of your drop shuffle, and then you throw them. Okay, again, you don't follow them down unless you've done ground attack. But it's a very good one if they're just headhunting boxers, for example. That's why if you come against the boxer, you know, he's not expecting it, just drop down, and then once you've done a few hits, cut. You know, last resort, but really, if you can't match the upper body movement, to drop down to take it down, best way. But it gives you options, and that's what Splash Hands is about. It's not all about just stick to this. I mean, this works as a practice, but in the fight, you need to know all angles. If you need this tool, then use it. Along with the blue belt syllabus, level 3, there is also a set of forms of the advanced browns. We did the browns in the last set, now we're doing the advanced browns in the blue belt. So it's a slightly bigger, more expanded version of the form. So everything again is jump shuffles, and large jump shuffles here, and jump shuffles here. Because advances teach you the same thing the jump shuffles and drop shuffles do, how to expand power in the movement. So we're just taking the principles the browns take in level 2, and then we're taking the principles that the advanced crowns take in level 3, and we're applying them to our drilling formations so that we can become better and sharper at them. So we do need to use the browns, we know how, and we can apply them quite quickly, quite fast, with great power and structure. Because the first thing you want to do is drop shuffle or jump shuffle and get caught leaning over. It's a very, very fun system, and it's a very, very fun section to the syllabus, but it is a lot of hard work. But if you do that, the next level will be a lot more rewarding, because you're not going to have to worry about your shuffles and your leg strength. Okay, you will have that already. And again, like I said, it helps you with the advanced browns. So, play with the drills as well. You don't have to do the reset, because again, I understand that there's no jab, punch, uppercut here like we will do here. So what you could do is jab and an uppercut, unshuffle, jab, uppercut, unshuffle. You could punch, jab, uppercut, punch, jab here, punch, jab, uppercut, punch, jab, punch, jab, uppercut, punch, jab, or jab, punch, elbow, yeah, you get the idea. So play with it. Just because these are the only drills I've shown you doesn't mean you can't expand. As long as the techniques are the same, you can add anything in. You could do this on a moving square drill, if you've done a square drill around the room. You can also do it using 45 degree angles and different angles as well. So I hope you have fun with that and really expand and play with that one. There's a lot to work up. So don't forget to practice your shuffles normally as well. So this system you can come in and learn it in a class formation where you will learn for 1 hour at a time on a Tuesday night for £5 per session. It's a very, very good rate for the amount that you will learn, and you will learn with other people as well, but you will learn at your own rate, and it will take you time to progress. If you come in for a course, the course is £400 for five solid days of 5 hours work per day, and that will give you the entire kit that you need and hopefully the grade of blue belt when you've finished. So you will attain all these skills and you will go through them with bag work, applications, pad work, and sensitivity drills as well, and that will give you everything you need to go away and practice that. But you would walk away with the blue belt providing you complete the whole course. But that works out 25 hours for a session, so really you're looking at 25 weeks, one hour per week if you were going to do this either on your own or in class formation. So it's a good way to do, but there's benefits to both ways, so yeah, have a look and see. But you can take these away with you today and you can practice jump shuffles and learn a lot from that yourself. So yeah, it's a very, very good thing to do. So hope you have fun. If you have any questions, please let me know, and I will speak to you soon for our next grade. Thank you very much. Take care.